a powerful force that swept Trump into the White House on a wave of bad cologne and Russian urine. That's right, economic anxiety. Trump tapped into something that had been brewing for a decade or more in small towns like Hazleton, Pennsylvania, home of the Hazleton area Cougars. Also home, in 2006, to one of the nuttiest anti-immigration laws ever passed.
Mayor Barletta got the Hazleton City Council to adopt, by a vote of 4-1, a new ordinance that would fine landlords who rent to illegal immigrants, fine employers who hire illegal immigrants, and designate English as the town's official language.
English is the official language? That would mean they could only listen to the Justin Bieber parts of Despacito. Oddly, this was the same mayor who had spent 5 years welcoming the newcomers who were revitalizing his dying coal town.
He was our friend. He cooperated with us. He even made a playground for us to welcome the Latinos and the immigrants that were coming into town. And suddenly he changed. I was surprised.
I know the feeling. A lot of us have been surprised lately. But the town soon learned that making life miserable for immigrants is the federal government's job, not the mayor's. It was an expensive lesson.
A federal judge has ordered the city to pay $1.4 million as a result of that battle over the Illegal Immigration Relief Act, money that will be paid by taxpayers.
Sorry, Hazleton Cougars, no new uniforms this year. You'll have to wait till next year to change the mascot. Now, Sam, I imagine you're saying, why are you telling me this? I know small towns can be closed-minded. That's why I moved here to Brooklyn to make it as a feminist DJ. First of all, rock on, blood sister. And second, Hazleton wasn't alone.
Fremont, Nebraska passes an ordinance that makes it almost impossible for illegal immigrants to live or work there.
Valley Park passed a new version of a law that makes it a crime to rent homes to illegal immigrants.
That Farmers Branch ordinance requiring landlords to verify that renters are in the U.S. illegally.
These laws are so dumb, yet so popular in small towns. What are they, cold shoulder tops? I paid for a shirt. Give me the whole f-ing shirt, okay? All these local ordinances had two things in common, failure and this guy.
Chris Kobach is an attorney running for Kansas Secretary of State, and he helped draft the ordinance.
We want the attorney Chris Kobach to represent the city of Fremont in this matter.
Ew, you do? You know he's not very good. Okay, you'll figure it out.
The city's lead attorney, Chris Kobach, says Mayor Barletta and city officials are simply trying to protect people from the very real threat of illegals. Kobach pointed to several murder cases and other violent crimes where the suspects were illegals.
Sure, if by several you mean less than one a year. I mean, by that measure, there were several Pennsylvanians abetting pedophilia, but that doesn't mean we should ship Penn State to Mexico. Before he became Trump's voter fraud imp, Kobach was a lawyer for the ironically named Fair, whose attitude about immigration you can probably deduce from the fact that they use Trump's hair in their logo.
Fair is a national anti-immigration lobbying organization classified as a hate group by the Southern Poverty Law Center.
I am the drafter of this ordinance. It's on our website. All the statutes cited in there, they do come out of our shop.
What's your shop's return policy? Because your merch is shit. Fair's busy little bigot bees went buzzing around the country pollinating small towns with their boilerplate anti-immigrant laws. Then when those laws were inevitably challenged in court, the towns would hire a certain hotshot Harvard lawyer to defend them.
Hazleton, Pennsylvania, Valley Park, Missouri, Escondido, California have said, no, we're going to fight. We're going to pay the cost.
We? The cost is your fee, you dick, plus the plaintiff's court costs since you lost. I mean, not to mention the human cost.
They don't want us here. If you go to buy food at one place or the other, they would stare at you like, okay, we voted for you to get out of here. Why are you here?
The immigration ordinance has left many restaurants, rentals, and stores empty.
My grandson has lost all of his friends. I mean, literally everyone in the neighborhood that he used to play with, except for one child, has left.
A sad white child with no friends? I think that kid may have a bright future. Kobach tap danced from town to town selling unsuspecting white people a law they didn't need for a problem they didn't have, then leaving their towns divided and broke. Kind of like a racist music man.
Why, Chris Kobach, you old flim-flam man. What are you doing here in Becky City?
Well, I heard your town's chock full of immigrants.
Heavens, you're right. So what?
I'll tell you so what. Well, you're in a pickle, little town. Immigrants, I say, right here in Becky City. Why, they're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're bringing tacos.
Not tacos.
Oh, yeah, a taco truck on every corner. Next thing, your kids are dropping words like gracias and pato. That means duck.
Oh,
the right way to come here, from Europe, before World War II. But don't worry, I have a solution. A cool new law provided by me for a modest fee, banning those illegals permanently.
Well, cool, I guess that's all solved then.
Is it though?
Thanks, Mr. Kobach.
Becky City was my town. Now they suspect me 'cause I'm brown. We used to live in harmony, and I...
No, this story's about me.
Well, thank God we got rid of that criminal element.
Oh, I kind of miss him. He was hot.
Yeah, but it's for the best. That poorly drafted law has solved all of our problems, right?
No, you're in a pickle.
You're still in a pickle.
That law's unconstitutional.
Then why'd you write it?
And you're in for a long and costly, ugly legal fight. They don't want you to have your law, and that old ACLU is lawyering up against you. But you've got something on your side. A crack attorney, who is me, who can represent you for a modest fee, $100,000 U.S. Who's with me?
Yeah!
Yeah, hey, bad news.
Bad news.
I'm a really shitty lawyer.
It sucks.
I do, and I lost your case like I lost all the others.
Now we really in a pickle,
pickle, pickle, pickle.
But it's okay, you see, it's all right for me. I've collected my staggering legal fees. Now your law's struck down, I've torn apart your town, and I'm gonna have to empty all your coffers. 'Cause, by the way, you owe the plaintiffs like a couple of $1 million for their legal fees. Like, we really lost this one.
Oh my God, you're the f***ing worst.
I regret sleeping with you.
Becky City welcomed me. Now there's such hostility. I guess I'll close my store and go.
Goodbye.
Where did Kobach go?
On to the next small town, I suppose.
Well, shit. Our town's in debt. ProPublica's written an article calling us racist. And my favorite taco shop closed.
We're in a pickle.
Oh, we're in a pickle.
Mr. President? Sure, I'll come on down to D.C. and help you out.
We're all in a pickle!
But let's not lose sight of the fact that the person hurt worst here is me!
We're all in a pickle!